Everyone's favorite bake shop is celebrating a milestone. It was in May 1966 that the very first Goldilocks store opened, which means 2016 is their 50th year. They've partnered with Adobo Nation to bring you the series called Golden Moments. And this week, we highlight the origins of the company both in the Philippines and in America. A toast to Goldilocks, and here's to more Golden Moments.
For most Filipinos, Goldilocks is more than just a fairy tale character. It is a Pinoy institution and tradition. A brand that has helped families create 5 decades of sweet and delightful memories. Auspiciously enough, the origins of Goldilocks go back to 1966, soon after a birth in the family of sisters Milagros Yee and Clarita Go.
50 years ago, my mother had to do an emergency flight to Albay because her sister, Clarita, was having premature labor.
And then when my brother was born premature, we all had to go to Manila.
It took a few months for him to grow in the hospital before he could be taken home. So in the meantime, here's my mother and my aunt doing not much at home. They were housewives. And so they started baking and cooking, and they would sell their ensaymada, the mamon, the cake slices, or whatever pastries they made, and they did very well. So that's when they hatched up starting a little bakery.
They rented a small place in my uncle's Pasong Tamo apartment. I think it was my other aunt, si Auntie Mer, who came up with Goldilocks. It was just right.
They started with halo-halo and palabok. Very soon after that, the fresh lumpia followed. We also trained in the bakery. We learned how to bake cakes, make bread. And this is how it was growing up. We were heavily involved in the nitty-gritty of the business. So that's the history, that's the origin back in 1966.
It was 10 years later when all that Goldilocks goodness finally reached American shores.
Ang unang Goldilocks sa America was in Houston, Texas. And then during the early 80s, nagbukas ng another branch sa California, which was in South San Francisco.
There was a small bakery here up in Calan. It used to be Betsy's. And then I think the owners were selling the business. So tamang-tama, my mom and my aunt, they were here that time. They decided, why not try Goldilocks?
This was just like a hobby for the two sisters, which every hobby that they kind of went into grew.
We did everything that we had to do to operate that store.
Walang baker, my husband was doing the pandesal. I was in the kitchen doing talagang cooking.
Binabalot namin yung mga mamon, and then thousands and thousands of pulvoron ang binabalot namin on a weekly basis.
So talagang anything that we came out with, talagang ubos. Especially pag holidays, my goodness, parang we don't sleep.
You know, if Filipinos wanted to meet up, it was the place to go. Everybody knows where Goldilocks was, so that was the meeting place for everyone.
All day long, walang patidang tao, ang pila hanggang labas all the time.
Goldilocks continues to grow through hard work, dedication, and an uncompromising commitment to total customer satisfaction.
The founders were very, very strict on the standards. Yung quality ang number one sa kanila.
The principle we hold on to that's been taught to us, number one is no shortcuts. Number two, the importance of the customer.
It's really an honor talaga to mabigyan namin ng kaligayahan, you know, the Filipinos here in America.
It's not just a reminder of home, but they know that we have been part not just of their day-to-day meal, but we've been part of their celebrations, their milestones.
And 2016 happens to be a milestone year for Goldilocks. What was once upon a time a pleasant pastime for two sisters has flourished into a real life happily ever after.
We're celebrating our 50th anniversary this year in the Philippines.
On May 15th. And it's a big, big celebration, especially in the Philippines. Kasi imagine, we've been in the business for 50 years. Taman-tama, Goldilocks, golden years.